Okay, so from last time, what was I doing? Entity stuff, export, importing, read position. Okay, I needed to fix this. I'm pretty sure it's what I had to do. Whatever the hell this is. It's just. So just reading node. No, it won't be. It'll be like position. Okay. So for this, we need to pass in node. Was it position 3D? What's it look like? 9, 0. There we go. What I need is something that actually checks if it exists first, actually, so. Call it data node then. No, that makes sense. Keep it down there. Where's position 3D? Is it like, yeah. Okay, that fixed up. So it comes to here, goes in through position and orientation. So this is what. negative 500. Okay. Okay. Now, do I want to? Because I need to try catch around this stuff, don't I? Or do I? I would because it's position 3D. That out further back out. It'll take it back out to wherever YAML read entity is. Import state data from file. YAML read entity. Okay, so let's say I go back and I modify this to fail out, right? Great. Then I say this is a string now for whatever reason. Fill the parse YAML state data, no parse map type as float. Oh, it's map type now, is it? Looks like a string to me. Whatever it does. Make sure we actually have the name. Native. Let's try that. So there's one thing I want to do. I want to make sure there has to be good, useful logging before I start scaling and expanding this. Otherwise, it'll become an impossible to figure stuff out afterwards. Successfully parsed entity that 09. Really? Oh yeah. Okay, so that says specifically where the issue was. I like it. Mm-hmm. I kind of like it. I don't like the fact that I have to like move this try catch outside of it though. I kind of need it here. I really do. Okay. So what I need to do then is I need to bring the resources and the data those through now. So I can actually put this data in. If I can find what I'm looking for. Realistically, it'd be these pools and loaders. Where's M position pool come from? There you are. This would have to be a third party kind of deal, wouldn't it? Data pools. And I'll just leave it as a header for the moment. State pools and data pools. Think I'll go with state actually. Which for the moment just really encompasses just this, right? Would it also require like working with ECS group? Probably. Gonna have to th think that probably yes, really. Because the states would be intrinsically tied to the group, the entities that do exist. So yeah. You know what? Oh, I'll just leave this like staples. It's just that ECS can be brought in separately. Because this will grow probably large enough as it is. Then I need something similar for this. I could even perhaps I don't think M position pool really has anything special in the application. Need to say it's a pool if it's already part of the state pools. It's a position state pool. Okay. Stage that, we don't need this anymore. Not directly anyways. Freezer. Freezer state management, something like that. Bam. Pause for drink. Okay. I'll leave resources for the moment, but I'll at least pass state data through. So, import HPP. Yeah, I need to pass it to the import. Data from file. There you are. Okay, so we got it through that, then we got to go through data pools. Sorry, state pools. Got to go entity, I should say. State pools, position for entity. Equals position. Or actually, no, because it'd have to be, as in here, it'd be, it's a new thing of it. Position equals Okay. Can I return? Figured as much. I need new state pools. Pointer. That should take us the way the one and whatever this is. 0, 0, 0. So this is the local one, and this is the one from the other with a 5. Yes. Okay. So that would be for reading it, anyways. I'll probably figure out something. When I have more types, I'll figure out something probably a little bit better for this. But that's okay for the moment. Let's see if we can add this translation.hpp. Group trans. Oh, right. Group translations, right? Yeah, I don't ha I can't convert it right away. Because if I have, what was one of the dependencies? 2 compared to A compared to B. Okay. D. That's a 0, 1 that needs to be converted to a 0, 2. So let's do it here. So it's group ID 1, but it needs to be converted to group ID type 2. So do 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 do. Normalize group of one. Yeah, this needs to be converted. Okay, actually. Can I return? I only really need it here. So actually, yeah, I will just leave it in line here. Return a failure case. Otherwise, bool. Return the phone null handle instead. Or there, that one. Okay. So we've got the normalized group ID of 1. That's what we read. We are currently double checking that we are actually within inside of state data D 01. So what I want to do, group translations, I only have 2 of them, 1 and that. Okay. I need to make sure that gambler identity. I don't want to throw from this. Well, this is YAML, so this throws anyways. Standard, I really do hope standard exception actually allows for string. standard exception. Constructor. There's nothing. It's empty. Can I? Format error. God, I am I'm almost using I'm using exceptions as flow control. I hate myself. I can return false because it already. Do I want to start like creating an error code system set for this? Not good. I mean, obviously the return's never going to happen. Interesting. Target group for the data. Hey, not found. Visiting. Wait, what? Did it just never? Okay, yeah, that works. Oh no, so we did, which is the first one. I just need to provide it with the one that doesn't have. Let's say it's corrupted. We got a different bad value in here. But otherwise, it should work. One. Okay, I need a property to stringify these as well, so I can actually read them properly. Okay, I need a string. Okay. Oh, this is not okay. Print width will be the number of bytes times 2. Width. We'll uppercase it. We'll set fill for zeros. That's a bit much, but that'll have to work. Okay, let's try this. This eat a what entity? Nope, doesn't like it. No set W. IO manip. That makes it way more readable, thank you. O1 got converted to O2. EE. Local, local. Non-local, non-local. Okay, good. And then when we get back out, what was it? We have that one added to the correct location as well. State pool's position. It'll be this one, right? 1111. -1, yeah. Okay. So, with all that, do I want to do resources? Not quite yet, but I really should. But I don't really have any state data that actually operates on resources yet, so I can't really implement that. Okay, let's get the basics on reading done. Or, you know what? No. What I'll do is I'll have an empty struct type. Resource data. Much like state pools, resource pools, sorry. Be empty, but I'll still have it and I'll still pass it around. I think, unless yeah, I'll just pass it through for now. Okay, looks like Lang D decided to break, so let's reopen this again. That brings it through almost entirely. Okay. Now I'm going to do the writing. Right. This will be a separate set of okay, export group state. Right now it's still it is still the same, isn't it? Anything that's local is automatic. Anything that's okay. I'm just thinking of the implications of, like, because if I have the ability to overwrite data from older entities, then I need to actually have like both the old and the new state available, perhaps. Or everything that's up to the current dependency, really. All the dependence data. In order, okay. You know what? Okay, I'll just focus on this. In order to determine differences from the lower tiers, I need to have the old state available. I'm not sure how to do that yet. Not sure. But we'll focus on the more simple one of just exporting what we already have. Just doing a full export in the directory we're giving. And determining if it's even a directory in the first place. So much like this, so export group state. If standard file system, let's see how this goes. Can we see if it has is file? Checks whether status is known. File type known, none. Path. Okay. We can check if it has. Okay. If YAML path dot has stem is the one I'm looking for. Or is it extension? Or is extension the one I'm looking for? Extension. File of some sort. What equals YAML? Does extension return the dot? Yes. General error, then we got to go with oh, Givel. Given. I mean, does it really matter if the extension doesn't really matter. If it has an extension, attempted to export. Else if can I actually determine if it's a directory or not? Like, exists already. If it already exists, then we're going to go with it. We know it exists, so we gotta check. Standard file system is regular file. Is directory YAML path unsupported. That's true, actually, because now think about it. What if you want to like just save it up as a single YAML file? Right now, I'm trying to like keep all the data split up in things to make it easier for a version control system. But I still want to be able to probably export it as a single YAML file. If you want to just like have a single file, you export. No, but then no, that makes no sense, because then you can just zip up the entire directory and be the same thing anyways. No, that's silly. Yeah. So we're just going to do this. Return false. To an existing directory at that. Now, not sure if I want to actually clear out the directory before I go in yet. Maybe. Okay. Let's say it doesn't exist. It doesn't exist in the file system. Then I got to check if. Determine if it's a file or directory. Has extension. Can I actually create a directory that's like, I can. So checking if it's an extension or not doesn't really make any sense. Okay, can I create a directory? Parent directory must exist. So I need to go through all the previous ones. Can I not? But create directories. Three executes for every element of P that does not already exist. P already exists, the function does nothing. Okay, so create directories looks like it'll be the one I want. Standard. Create directories. She takes the YAML path and takes the error code. if there's an error code, right? Let's just do. With the second argument of that. An error may be reported. None throwing overload. Oh, okay, so it's a none throw. Oh, that's that throws, that doesn't. Okay. I'll take the none throwing, please. Otherwise, it's just pretty generic. Fail to create directory to export YAML state. Do we actually export? We will in a second. Entity. Okay, let's see if we can get the. Do I need this anymore? I don't think so. I do need the save state stuff. Nope, I don't think so. All right, I'll just leave it for the moment. So back to this, we got that, okay. Tester, we got the search paths. The search paths even matter in this case? No. Search paths are gone. Out of the way. 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 Application. So what you're complaining about? I don't have it yet. You are correct. I won't have it yet. Okay. Okay, we created it. Presumably here will be, what was it, test.dir? So, libs. I don't see it. Oh, there it is. Okay. And what did it say actually when it happened? Do-do-do-do-do. Okay, this time it'll exist, so it'll go through this one. I'm sorry, what? What? I'm sorry, what? This path does exist. We know this path exists. Okay, now it's checking. Okay. All right, then at this point, we're just going to have to start creating files, aren't we? So one thing I probably want to try to keep are these. How can I share these guys? Through, like, probably. Whatever. Just imagine I'll probably do something similar to this. First of all, we'll figure out group dependencies, I think. Dang it. Okay. So what do I need to export? I need to export. I actually already kind of have this here, don't I? There's basically this, and it just goes through like that. Yeah, so that's not too difficult. So, okay, what I did previously was this. And that's just no good. Not very useful. I need to go through and check if the group exists. Up to the permanent temporaries or persistent temporaries. So, so this is the normalized group ID. This is the actual group ID. Then I gotta go to ECS groups dot group. Group equals null pointer. Continue. Node dot need the name and then the group ID. To generate dependencies node. Otherwise, we need the YAML emitter stuff. Stream. Not quite. Export 2317. Okay, included from here, instantiation here. P group name, what's name? String view. It can't write a string view. Does that work? Control Shift B, come on. Parse includes running semantic highlights. It used to, like, VS Code used to work so nicely. Save it. And now it just likes to keep, like, the servers or whatever, just keep, let's actually open the directory, shall we? Just keeps losing track of things. So 2, 3, that looks about the same. So we can do this next, ret val equals export data to file. Get the persistent group information. Return false. Basically the same thing. Index data or something similar. I think I already have a function for this hiding somewhere else. State, group dependencies, index data file. Yes. It's not that, it's a index generator, right? Just takes the data and writes a node. Okay. It's basically the same thing, except it's this one. Okay, well, let's try it. Amazing, and amazing. That is correct. Okay, what's the time looking like? Okay. So it's close to an hour and a half, hour 40 now. So I think I'll call it there with the dependencies and index data being exported as well as the state data imported. Next time I'll get the rest of the state data and I'll have to clean up the code and clear it out of the application. but it's looking all right. It's looking solid. I think it'll work. Whatever. Cheers. Okay. So today, what was I doing? I exported dependencies and index data. Now I need to export the actual resources and state data. Now I don't really have much of a handle on resources yet. So, I mean, how does resources work? I'd have to import all of them, wouldn't I? And then possibly, would that allow, Yeah. Okay, so first of all, state data. How would this happen? I have to go through all the items that are in memory. As well as dealing with items from dependent objects. Because like dependencies, since their data can be overwritten or modified. Would I do it all at once or just one at a time? I may just do it all at once in one go. So let's just start with YAML path. / state data. This is the root. We'll go through ECS groups. Would it be ECS groups? I may have to actually. I need to do more work on the dependencies. I really do. Okay, just state pools. Resource pools. Export state group state data. Thank you. Path. I'm not even sure if I want to actually keep this. Groups, state pools, resource pools. Okay. How would I determine how to go through all the entities? That'd be quite something, wouldn't it? And I want to iterate through all of them, obviously. Okay. What I may need to do then is, I need, okay. I may want to have to import index generator data for these for the dependent groups so that I can determine which ones are still active, perhaps. I'd also need like a Either I do by active or I do by removals. I may want to split index generator up into two different distinct groups. Because one, these will be index generators because these are modified locally. And then the old groups I'd have to change up to be some other type. What exactly do I do on these other ones? Okay, I can at least determine what the active entities are for this one. I can generate a list that would use on export. Active, and I can, yeah. A vector? Yeah. I mean, they would actually be effectively the same because they'd have to have a maximum number, so it's recycled. But then I'd have to have a specific list for removed items. Can we remove items? Or I just want to make them like inactive through changed data. Not entirely sure. Okay, I'll kind of So, I'm going to have to generate a list, which means I need to lock this up. So, is it scoped or unique lock? Which one was the new one? Scoped or unique? Scoped is the new one. Okay, what I really. So I can temp. Okay. Then we'll run export state locally using next free index recycled. Okay, then. Yeah, I guess I'm just gonna have to go through them. Maybe. Reserve the size of next free index minus dot size, just in case it's a fairly large delta. I guess I just kind of have to move forward, really. Recycle with iterator equals that. Do this. We're just going to have to go through. Sorry, not for if. Or, oops. Not equals the I. Oh, I need to sort that as well. So it starts in a small, goes up. Then we go through like this. Then we just like. Sorry, C group ID. Or I. Now this is going to become quite unwieldy on larger spaces, I would imagine. Unless I'm going to start doing things like, save or make lists, keep them in memory of what's been modified since I was loaded. Or if I just want to take the hit during save time to build and generate these lists. Maybe. Whatever, we'll generate a list. Do-do-do-do. And we have to go through by group, actually, as well. This. We go through by group, going up. Then from that, if then we just continue. Otherwise, auto into list. Do I want to keep... No, because entities have to be removable. They must be. Okay. Then at this point, we'd have to push back new entity, like go process them somehow. So yeah, like basically we'd call this. So for the moment, it'd be path, slash okay, clang's broken again. For the entity. Whole bunch of nothing right now. Oh, yeah, no, it, That's what I'm looking for. Why don't I just slap these all together?
Supposedly.
Okay, so the entity is, first of all, much like this, it'll be optional. Equals VCS get XID. Do group ID of entity. Then I could just run this instead. Thank you. Wait, hold on. Did I? Yeah, I did do the dependencies correct. So it'd just be like, this would be for like all the subgroups. And then the persistent group. It's not equal to the persistent group. Do I just not need to pull in groups? For ECS groups, persistent. Yeah, that should be it. Oh, I don't actually have it. Or rather, or can I just do optional? You can do group ID The default data, which is persistent, normalized group ID. Then the out node. Then we got the entity ID. Oh. Then I'd have to go through state pools position find entity if that then we'll go through and just basically do the YAML. Equals, you see, this is with the data, which will be like back to export. So foe entity ID to string for entity, we have u.what. I'm gonna need some more stuff. Presumably, okay, whatever. Persistent group. I mean, at the moment, I'll have a few. Yeah, okay. Okay, let's see how this fails. It doesn't fail. Okay, very interesting. But it didn't write things out, so not quite there yet. Okay, is it just because it doesn't think there's any group, any entities whatsoever in here? Okay, that actually makes sense, because these guys will have none of that information, but the persistent should, at least. It has these guys. These guys are all active. So he writes it. Emitter. State data plus this stuff. Okay. Does it just need to like be reloaded or something? No. Oh, I didn't create the directory. Ooh. Okay. If it was created, otherwise, if it's in this. Okay, yeah, no. Create the subdirectories. This, and then we'd also want to do this. There we go. And that's a bit more of a slightly more readable version of the entities instead of just plain old numbers. I'll probably want to do something where it's like this dash, like editor name. Why are these all group 14? Is group... What's the value of that then? The max group value, okay. That's the so this is 15, and then this is 14. Oh, that's the index bits. Okay, we can probably do this a little bit easier. If that not equal that, we're just going to do it this way. Okay, and we just throw that in. Nope, still throwing out group ID. Interesting. It never actually comes through this time. Okay, okay. And one thing we want to do for this is this of index ID. We just want that. We don't want to. I mean, if there's a group. That's not very good. Because if there's a group starting at zero, then those ones will overlap with the files from this group. So actually, yeah, having them just be persistent like that, show up as like 0e, 0xe, it does make sense. So I will leave it like that. Or will I? What if I was to change it to be a P? For persistent. PNT for persistent temporary. I just don't want to overlap. Because presumably eventually E. Okay, this is. Okay, maybe not go with this strategy then, actually. Now that I think about it. What I can do is do a P plus that. P dash that. So it's a persistent entity with this, and then it has a E or whatever, or gets rid of the E. Like that. Okay. That should knock off the overlap. It's persistent. So that way they're all in a group P whatever. All the others start at zero. So you have a bunch of zeros for external dependent modified entities, and then P dash for the locals, persistent ones.
Okay, I think I can live with that. Got that. He's got nothing, nothing, nothing. Nothing, nothing. Do. Okay, let's see what happens if we say, hey, data E, which is up here still, has. It's actually up here. Thank you very much. Index data has, it's 1. 1, 2. Okay, what's this? 10 million. Actually, just 1 million. Let's see how long this takes. Wait, no way. Yeah, that didn't work. Interesting. Okay, go to import. Go to here, find the data. Okay, group name. The data E, file path, that. The data E, index data, great. Going to go inside. What's it got? Next free index. It's a million. Impressive stuff. Fail to create directory tester to export YAML state. No error given. Really? So if the directory already exists, then I'm going to have an error. Is that it? Here we go. And it quickly ballooned beyond the capability of VS Code to handle that repository. Okay, cancel. I'm going to imagine if I open this up, it's going to be terrifying. Okay, well that's a not great aspect of Okay, I'm going to open it up and I'm just going to like. Okay, I'm going to open up another console. See if I can get engine tester state data. Okay, so actually, yeah, there's a lot of things in here beyond even the buffer size. Nice. Ah, that was actually that generated at 1.2 gigs real fast. Okay. Point is, yes, it does work on extraordinarily large data sets. Amazingly, well, so. I just want, if I'm going to do testing on large data sets, I need to do it on another directory outside of here. Okay. But it's workable. It really is. Okay, it's still trying to recover. Cancel it. Open a new window. Oh no. Nope. Come on. Come on, you can kill yourself. There we go. Okay, let's open up a new. And there we go. We're good? We're good. Okay, we're back up. Okay, we've got the 20 now. Okay. Okay, with that all sorted, let's get rid of the old stuff. The basics all done. Let's get it out of here. So, this goes away. State dependency, import state. Okay, if we do this. So now we're importing, we're exporting. That means At least for the moment. Okay, can I put this in? Like that. Okay. Okay, there's a few items that just leaves moving resources over, since that's the bigger one right now. Or, do I want to deal with overriding resources? If I don't over... Okay, actually, resources don't even have an ID. They're just all string-based. Ah, crap. Okay. So that's what I'm going to do next time. I think I'll call it here, and I'll actually attach this to the last hour and a half. So this will be a 2.5 hour episode-ish. And then next time I'll go through and start adding IDs to resources so I can start serializing them as well. So I think I'll call it there. Cheers.